Today we're going to learn how to print in Python. It is really straightforward. All you need is the print command, and you can just go ahead and type that in at this idle prompt right here. I'm typing in print. Follow that by parentheses and a double quote. One of these is a double quote. We're going to need two of them. Then type in what you want to print out on the screen. I'm going to print out "Hello World." Close your double quote, close the parentheses, and then at that point you hit enter, and the computer will print out exactly what you've got in between those quotes. Now, how exactly does this work? Right here, this print is what's called our function name. It's really similar to what you've already used before in mathematics. In mathematics, you've probably used sine or cosine. In this case, we're using a function called print. And just like sine, cosine, we follow it with parentheses. Inside those parentheses goes the data that we're giving the function. We might give sine and cosine pi over 4. Close parentheses. And in this case, we're giving the print function a set of text, "Hello World." And that is right here on what we've typed in. Unlike with mathematics, with computers we can easily give functions several sets of parameters that go inside those parentheses, and it doesn't even have to be numbers, it can also be text. Or even an entire customer record or a 3D object that we want to have displayed on our screen. Now inside of this idle prompt, I'm going to hit the up arrow 2 times so that I've got the cursor right on the print line. I'm going to hit enter. It'll copy what I had before down here so I can type again without having to retype the whole thing. And I can go ahead and say, if I were to say learning Python is great, because if I say that a whole lot of times, maybe I'll believe it, it'll go ahead and print that out. Whether or not the computer knows that it's true or not, I can get the computer to say anything. Now, why are these quotes so important? Let's do another example here. I'm going to take the up arrow a couple times, and I'm going to go ahead and print out 10 plus 10 inside of quotes. Like before, the computer prints out exactly what I had between the quotes, 10 plus 10. If I were to go up here, do this line again, but this time take out the double quotes, and the number of spaces I have doesn't really matter in this case, particularly if you're outside the quotes. What's going to happen is it's going to evaluate that particular item that I typed in as a mathematical expression and then output the result. 10 plus 10 inside of quotes prints out exactly that, 10 plus 10. 10 plus 10 with no quotes is going to go ahead and evaluate it as a mathematical equation and give you the result. We can do that with a lot more terms. In this case, I've got 10 plus 10 minus 5 times 20, and it'll go ahead and give me a negative 80. Order of operations applies. We'll talk about that in a later lesson, but the negative 5 times 20 happens first, and I've got the result of my mathematical expression. Now that's great, but if I come up here and I select "Hello World," and I take out the quotes for the "Hello World," when I go ahead and hit enter, the computer gives me an error. "Hello World," it says, syntax error, invalid syntax. Now that may not give me a whole lot to go on that something's wrong, but what the computer is saying is it's trying to evaluate "Hello World" as a mathematical expression. It has no idea what "Hello World" is as a mathematical expression, and it says the syntax of that expression is wrong, which is true. It's not a mathematical expression. There's nothing for it to evaluate, and I can't print it out. As somebody starts to learn how to program, sometimes they can get confused what goes inside of quotes, what doesn't go inside quotes. If it is a mathematical expression, then it does not go inside quotes, and what comes out will be the answer to that expression. If it goes inside of quotes, that's exactly what's going to print out what's inside those quotes. We can actually combine these. I'm going to go up a few lines and do this 10 plus 10 line. The answer to 10 plus 10 is, if I hit enter, it's going to, just like before, print out exactly what I had before, but I can also print multiple things. In this case, the key to doing this is right after the double quotes, not inside. I'm going to hit a comma and then do 10 plus 10. When I do that and hit enter, the computer prints both the first term, which is right here. The comma will translate into a space, and it'll print out the second term. This is 1, this is 2, this is 1, and this is 2. The whole 10 plus 10 is the second parameter that's going into the function. Remember then, you can list several different things and have them print out. In this case, I've got 5 different things. I hit the print, and it prints out those 5 numbers. The comma doesn't print out if it's outside the double quotes. You need to have those commas in there, though. If I print 3 and 4, the computer doesn't know if you want to add them, if you want to subtract them, or what you want to do with them, so I get that syntax error again. A common mistake is to do something like this. In this case, I get the syntax error. I do have a comma, but that comma is inside the double quotes, and the computer interprets that as something you want to print out, not something that's separating all the different things that I want to print out. I need to have that comma outside the double quotes. In this case, it prints out the answer is comma. Then the second comma counts as what is separating the different things that I'm printing out, and then I finally get my answer. All right, just to summarize then, what we've got is the print command. This is our function. All functions are followed by parentheses. Inside of those parentheses goes the data that we want to have print out. If we include inside of those parentheses double quotes, the computer will print out exactly what we've got between the double quotes. If we have multiple things that we want to print out, we can separate them by commas. And in this case, I've got 4 different things that are going to be printed out. This is my function name. Got the parentheses here. This is item number 1, item number 2, item number 3, item number 4. No commas will print out because no commas are inside those parentheses. And I've got my output. Those commas will always add an extra space in there. Later on, we'll show you how to format output so you don't get those extra spaces, but that's a little bit beyond the scope of this tutorial.